I am concerned about what is being taught in schools.
What do you mean, Mr. Past President?
Well, they do not know what the Iron Curtain was, for one thing.
Well, I can see how that would be confusing. Well, if you will excuse me, sir, I better be going.
You're sure? I need some time to think. I cannot believe history is being lost. I am going to use videos to help students learn history. I can get my friends to help. Yes, I will have my own school to help students. Maybe they will watch and learn. You see, some people think the Iron Curtain was like this fence, only much bigger. The good guys were on this side, and the ones on this side wanted to be on the other side, of course. Well, that was not real fact, and the Iron Curtain was a term, a phrase. Let's look back to 1946. Almost all of Central and Eastern Europe was in the area known as behind the Iron Curtain. The Soviet Union and the world was much different then. What was Eastern Europe like after World War II? In 1946, Winston Churchill said there was an Iron Curtain descending through the middle of Europe. Joseph Stalin blamed World War II on capitalist imperialism. The United States and Western Europe was not given much favor by him. Here is a list of the countries Winston Churchill was referring to in 1946. You see, these nations, well, these nations formed the Warsaw Pact in 1955 to respond to NATO. I can talk about NATO at another time. Right now it is about the Iron Curtain nations. Do you know who the United States president was in 1990? Yes, it was me, and those were some great days, if I say so myself. Thanks to the wisdom of several leaders before me, there were major changes during my term as president. It is time to get some fresh air. I love this great nation. We will always have difficulties to face, but if we work together, we can keep America strong. I hope you enjoyed today's history lesson. Let me know and I will come back for more.